Hubbleton. Let's try that again. Hello, Sobleton. We all having fun?
Yeah.
I can tell you, this has probably been the most nerve-wracking experience of our staffing life moving to two hotels. I hope you guys enjoy the new location. If you haven't, please go check out the gaming downstairs. Honestly, this has been phenomenal how well this hotel has been received. The crowd tonight just tells us exactly what we expected, which is what we were hoping we could be able to expand with our growth again this year to be able to handle more growth and be able to handle more people. Our goal is to start bringing more nightlife here over the next couple years and start adding more bigger events, bigger bands into the evening. So this is really going to become the nightlife hotel. So thank you guys so much. Really appreciate it, and I just, 15 years of Sobleton. I'm old, sorry. When we started this show back in 2008, I never would have expected to be standing in front of a crowd this big, let alone running a show that's in two hotels and probably gonna push close to 30,000 in attendance for the weekend. I thank all you guys. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's kind of with the 15 year, we've all kind of reminisced back. When I drive down to the show every year, I always travel past where the Crown Plaza used to be. It's now something else, new life form or something like that. And it kind of just hits me because it's nice to be going past the original place where we were. So, and we were 1,000 attendees that year. So that's a big growth in 15 shows to be able to get to where we got to. And it's all thanks to you guys, and it's thanks to all the staff and everything like that. So I know that I usually kind of share some of this stuff at closing ceremonies, but it's kind of heartwarming to see all you guys coming over here, and we were afraid we probably wouldn't have as much of an attendance our first year over here, as they blind me and non-blind me. They're screwing with me already. But I just wanted to thank you guys. If you can, please come to closing ceremonies tomorrow as we kind of close the show. We're going to be going over a whole lot of things. You'll probably see some tears. I'll try not to cry. I'm usually pretty good about that, but I will get misty. But I just want to thank you guys. This has been such a roller coaster of fun, and I just love seeing all you guys having all the fun over the weekend and enjoying yourselves. So thank you guys so much. I know you're not here to hear sappy me talk. I know you don't want to hear all the my stupid little things, but I just want to thank you guys. And with that being said, I will bring up Miss Heartless Aquarius as your MC for the night.
Oh, they've given me a microphone. If you guys know how loud I am in person, this was a mistake. Hello! Welcome to the 2023 Sobleton Masquerade! I am your master of ceremonies, Heartless Aquarius, the coolest cat on stage. Well, okay, maybe the second coolest cat on stage. Or as you know me, as unfortunately the algorithm has said, the person who made Piranha Plant into a princess. So I hope you're excited for an amazing masquerade where we're going to see these amazing craftsmen show off their cosplay skills and their presence on stage. It's going to be a fantastic time. I got to talk to them really quick, tried to calm down the nerves because they are super nervous, but they shouldn't be because they all look amazing. You are in for such a treat. So we can't have a masquerade without our lovely judges up here. Let's give a round of applause for the judges. So we have three lovely judges today. Page turn. There we go. So let's start off with Corianne Cosplay. Beautiful, beautiful. Oh, well, don't die. We just started. Corey Klein, better known by her alias Corianne Cosplay, has been a cosplayer in the Arizona community for almost 10 years. She is most well known for her League of Legends cosplays, but has also done a bit of The Legend of Zelda. Her most well known cosplay is her Xayah, that she worked on while getting her college degree in art education, which won best in category at PCF 2018. Corey's message regarding cosplay is that anyone and everyone can do it, and I believe in this too. You can do it. I know it's scary. You can do it. When Corey is not cosplaying or working on cosplay, she's either teaching her 6th to 8th grade students, playing video games, or doing other forms of art. You can follow her on Instagram at Mythical Majesty to see more of her creations. One more round of applause for Corey Ann Cosplay! Alright, next we have Andy Serpentine. Also, I am going to try my best to pronounce everyone's names correctly, but the universe likes to play its pranks on its silliest of gooses, so if I mispronounce, I am so sorry. That is on me. I am just very tongue-tied very easily. Andy Serpentine is a professional pet groomer and has been cosplaying since 2015. However, her love for nerd culture and animals has been in her heart since she was a little girl. A great lover of books and true crime, in her downtime she can usually be found reading or listening to a podcast or an audiobook. This combined with her favorite childhood TV shows such as Batman the Animated Series and Xena Warrior Princess would later become inspiration for many of her future cosplays. Andy aims for extreme detail with all of her cosplays and often adds her own little touches to the characters she chooses to portray. And this attention to detail and natural charm she uses while portraying a character that has not only earned her praise of many, but led her to winning costume contests as well as being featured in several mediums such as cosplay-related articles online and syndicated television. A firm believer that everyone is beautiful inside and out and that there is no wrong way to cosplay, Andy hopes to help inspire people from all walks of life to cosplay, just as she was inspired by others in the cosplay community. Taking cue from one of her favorite musicals, Rocky Horror Picture Show, Andy's message... Ooh, love all the Rocky Horror love. Andy's message to those who want to cosplay and may be hesitant to is to don't dream it, be it. One more round of applause! And last, but certainly not least, we have Nightmage. As everyone's favorite sparkly husband from Demon Slayer. Michael Nightmage Wilson was born and raised in Cleveland, Ohio. See, I told you, I get tongue-tied easily. I'm like, who can mess up saying Ohio? Me. And now resides in Youngstown, Ohio. A decorated 24-year-old deputy sheriff for the
Mahoning,
thank you, County Sheriff's Office in Ohio, Michael has been cosplaying since 2012. Having created over 350 costumes, Michael is an award-winning cosplayer with many of his creations being praised and displayed on numerous platforms in print and online. Michael is noted as one of the most influential and diverse male cosplayers in the world. Along with judging cosplay contests, Michael often hosts cosplay panels and workshops at conventions, showcasing the creative, positive, inspiring, and supportive side of cosplay. Having a love for acting and stunt work, Michael has worked on several Hollywood comic book movie productions. Michael is also an alternate for the 2006 reality show Who Wants to Be a Superhero, hosted by Stan Lee. Michael has worked on and has been featured in several fan films and productions, such as the popular YouTube series Man at Arms Reforged. Woo! Michael is also a spokesperson for the FX latex product Zombie Skin. Michael has also created various costumes for World Wrestling Entertainment superstars. In 2022, the word Nightmage was added to Urban Dictionary, describing some of many positive cosplay philosophies that Michael holds, along with us, the cosplay community. I was so worried when Urban Dictionary came up. I could not be the only one who was just like, where is this going? Genuinely loving to entertain, make a positive impact, and bring smiles, Michael often uses his costuming to bring awareness and participating in many charitable events, benefits, parades, birthdays, and hospital visits to children. This has led him to becoming a member of the esteemed costuming groups all over the U.S., such as the League of Heroes, the Heroes Alliance Ohio Branch, East Coast Avengers, Costumers with a Cause, and Superheroes to Kids in Ohio and Heroic Inner Kids. Michael often works closely with charity organizations as a sponsor and has partnered with over 200 various organizations across the world to fundraise and bring awareness to those organizations. Michael has received numerous awards for his charitable deeds, including the Outstanding Service Award from Credit credit where credit is due, the Cos Bravo Award, Electronic Sports Industry Most Influential Male Cosplayer Award, and most notably, the Presidential Volunteers Award from President Barack Obama in the White House. Can you tell I didn't get to the end of pre-reading all of this? That's amazing! If you wish to be a fan and follow at www.nightmage.com, and he is Nightmage across all social media platforms. Let's give a round of applause for Nightmage! The next part is about the MC for this year, but they're like, blah, like whatever. All right, so are we ready? Are we all good? Are you guys ready? That's the important part. Awesome. I love just everyone shoving Pokemon plushies in the air. Yeah. All right. So, just so you know, you are going to see a mixture of all of our categories today. Youth, novice, intermediate, masters, just all intermixed. So you're going to see a lot of amazing cosplayers, and I want you to make sure you show love to all of them because they all worked so hard. So, entry number one. We have officially started. All right, so this is an entry in the child self-made category. So this is Melody as Katara from Avatar: The Last Airbender. With the patience of my dad, Martin Sr. I play too much Genshin Impact. The guidance of my mom, Veronica, and the musical suggestion of my friend, Nick, I chose Katara because she is a very determined person who will do what she can to help her friends and family. Katara is the only Southern Water Tribe member who can waterbend. She will continue to practice until she masters it. Novice category. We have Veronica, cosplaying Veronica from Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagataro. Here's the girl who wrestles her romance for disgusting sheep-haired nerd, her desire to keep her love away from the bad girls with her furious eyes. Only she can make her senpai cry, but when he takes charge, she can be the most shy, a kitty with no gritty, a girl who wants to be in senpai's life tomorrow, the one and only Nagataro.
She's ill. The New York City, in a funky hotel. She took my heart, she took my money. She must have slipped me a sleeping pill.
It's going to be stuck in your head all weekend. All right, time for entry number 3 in the Masters category. We have Bleeding Fingers cosplay as Power from Chainsaw Man. You know, fun fact, when Power started becoming really popular, I was really out of the loop and I thought everyone just got really into Darling in the Franxx again out of nowhere. I have been corrected many times since then. All right, next we have entry number 4 in the novice category. We have Fruit Cause as Ruby Kurosawa from Love Live. Live? Live. I had them correct me and I forgot. Join Ruby Kurosawa as she sings about her favorite things, from zebras to cupcakes. Her big sister Dia will help her light up the stage, so turn on those light sticks and let's get ready to do our Rubisty! Bye. in just now. You wouldn't have seen him if I didn't point him out. Wow. I was just staring at the lights, just like, oh, shiny. And there they go again. I didn't even know they were coming. Sneaky. All right, time for entry number 5 in the Masters category. We have Grace Knight as Urza Scarlet from Fairy Tale.
Excuse me? Lucy, where did they find the cakes? Natsu, Gray, put them down. They were supposed to be a surprise. No one was supposed to know about them. I made them special to welcome our new friends from Sabaton to the Fairy Tale Guild.
On behalf of Sabaton, we are not responsible for what happens if you eat the forbidden food. Please be careful. Those are not real food, as yummy as they looked, and I wanted one. Oh, well. All right, speaking of food, it actually kind of works perfectly. Our next entry is number 6 in the Masters category. We have Noon Raccoon and Print Bash Props. I had a feeling that would happen. As Alcremie and Galar Trainer from Pokemon! Alright, it's the final match of the Pokemon League, and everyone is pumped to see the rising star and his ace take on the Galar's Pokemon champion, Leon. What will happen? Who will come out on top? Let's go to them now in the waiting room!
All right, Alcremie, it's time. We've fought and struggled every step of the way, and you've grown so very much. I couldn't be more proud of you. How are you feeling?
A little nervous, but we've overcome so many odds. I'll do my best and hope for a win. Leon is a pushover after all.
I've been saving a little something for you. A good luck charm to help bring some magic into our battle. It took me a long time to find it, and now seems like it's right.
A strawberry squeeze?
From the Hammerlock Cafe, our favorite.
Oh, I love it! It fills me with determination! I've achieved my greatest dream! I'm finally ready to challenge Leon. As my magical goyle final form, nothing can stand in our way now!
Oh, Grimmie, listen! The crowd's cheering for you.
Leon and his Charizard don't stand a chance against us.
Leon,
it's time to take the challenge and battle.
Here come the hurricane. What? Here come the hurricane. What? Here comes the hurricane. What? I'll dreamy. Oh, they'll come in this place to help the next storm. Oh, my sorcery and storm. Oh, how sweet. I'll dreamy, just like this. Get it back. Everybody move back. Watch the hurricane storm. And cleaning that up. Here comes the hurricane. What? Here comes the hurricane. Oh, here comes the hurricane. Oh, here comes the hurricane. Oh, all dreamy takes the crown.
All creamy. That will be my vocal stim for the next 24 hours. I apologize to anyone going near me. You know, I know I'm not supposed to eat forbidden food, but like, it looks so good. But let's move on to something that's less edible looking. What a weird way to phrase that. Moving on. So next is entry number 7 in the novice category. We have Cinderella as Boa Hancock and her snake from One Piece. I am allowed to do anything, for yes, I am beautiful. Sharp moon daggers, they move in the darkness. Will their target get away or fall prey to their sneak attack with advantage?
From exposure to the moon's energy waves, changing Eevee's genetic structure, it hides silently in darkness and lurks for prey. When night falls, the rings on its body begin to glow, striking fear into the hearts of anyone nearby.
I didn't see a contestant at all. Crazy, right? All right, time for entry number 10 in the Journeyman category. We have Guilty Rose cosplay as Byleth Eisner from Fire Emblem Three Heroes. Known to many as Ashen Demon, Byleth Eisner is known most often as Professor at Magrin Mach Monastery. After after fusing with the goddess Sothis, she is now known by a new name, Enlightened One. Riju, Link has found his way to the Yaiga's clans, the Yaiga clans hangout. Learning that he won't be able to just charge his way through, he knows he'll need a distraction. He has just the idea.
Yeah! On this train, the murderer of the Grand Duke has turned everyone into a suspect, the most predominant being myself, the Grand Duchess Sophia, his newly appointed wife. Every minute I hear the gossip spoken by those around me.
The more intimate someone is, the more dangerous they are. Don't you agree, Miss Sophia?
I'm Grand Duchess.
The feud between the Grand Duke and the Grand Duchess is no secret. It's clear what happened.
Grand Duchess is innocent. If they're looking for suspects, shouldn't they look into the other distinguished envoys first?
I mustn't entertain them, but there is only one man capable of such.
Don't forget the hidden storyline.
So what you're saying is?
All your skills are locked, so meditate behind closed doors and beat the beginner quest.
Wait, I have skills?
Handsome, elegant, truly the scholar. You are the peak master of Ching Ching.
Then the Ching Ching's the lowest of scum. I'm on the fast track to death if I say like this.
You can, you up, no can, no BB. Just do it, and don't go on fine.
What if I fail and all my B points drop to zero? What happens to my life?
Deleted, deleted. Unlock the OOC, level up your skills, the system wishes you future success. Here's to improving this stupid storyline, and for filling in all the potholes. Please continue all your hard work, and keep up the hero's satisfaction.
I'm stuck in all these plot points. I guess I'm still the villain after all. What was the point of unlocking the OOC? So many crimes are now getting blamed on me, making this better than I've ever seen.
The hero's here just for you, to take his revenge. Backing you in a corner. Your core detonates on the spot. Sorry, it seems you've died.
Oh, Airplane Girl, why? I blame you for this.
Listen, sorry you died, but your robe is so pretty. You're fine? Okay. I love when they also speak to me. Okay, entry number 15 in the novice category, we have Complacent Devil. We good? We good. As Rika Furude from Higurashi Nanako Komo ni. You see nothing. There's nothing going on behind the curtain. Well, in front of the curtain. All right, cool. Hailing from Hinimazawa. Yes, Rika Furude comes to the stage to perform the ceremonial dance of the walk. The Watanagashi, washing away the sins of the year. We can only hope that after tonight, no one is lost to the Oyashiro-sama's curse. Oh, they fighting. Oh, they fighting. it, and I am keeping your shoe. Oh, you want your shoe? Apologize. All right. Oops. I did not hit a contestant in the face with their own shoe. There is no evidence to prove otherwise. No, you didn't. Oh, we have another contestant, actually. So we have entry number 17 in the novice category. We have Zahira. They are cosplaying Violet Evergarden from Violet Evergarden. And her journey to reintegrate back into society after the war is over, as she is no longer a soldier, Violet Evergarden has dedicated her life to understanding the last words the Major ever said to her. I love you. Number 19 in the novice category, we have Neko Miku Cheese. They're cosplaying Kalinka Miku from Dino. Neko Miku Cheese as Kalinka Nurse, created by Dino. I'm a disembodied voice. Flowers. They're cosplaying Death/Wolf from Puss in Boots, The Last Wish. What an anime convention! Have you ever watched a movie or TV show and saw a character that made you go, yeah, I need to become them. No, I can't relate to that at all. That was me when I watched Puss in Boots: The Final Wish and saw Death for the first time. I mean, who wouldn't want to be a cool, red-eyed, scythe-wielding... Lobo? Lobo! Oh, is that Spanish? Oh, my extended family would hate me right now. That was all it took. A fictional character on a theater screen and a lot of hot glue. Smiles on everyone's faces and tries to incite a Wonderhoy feeling, as his co-star Emu would say, now give it up for Wonderland ex Showtime's prize director. For over 15 years, and I have never seen someone make a balloon animal on stage. That was amazing! Wow! I also feared it was gonna pop the whole time. Next, we have entry number 22 in the novice category. We have RJ and the Bandits! We're going a little indie right now because they are cosplaying Lambert, cult members number 1, 2, and 3 from Cult of the Lamb! Journey through Darkwood, the followers gather to ask their savior for a small favor. Yeah.
After a successful crusade, I can finally sit down and relax.
Oh, great leader!
Yes? What is it?
Well, me and a few others were just wondering if you would graciously gift us with a little inspiration?
Yeah, that sounds like
I too would love some inspiration.
I wanted to be poo. Look, I'd love to, but I'm very tired after scavenging 6 berries for all 20 of you.
Oh, please! Just a quick one?
All right, but make it a good one.
Yes!
What kind of song should we pick? It has to be a good song.
Because we should be a good song.
It's not a good song.
I still think we should have asked the poo instead.
Okay, I think we got it.
All right, then let's begin a random, creative, and not choreographed inspirational dance.
Gentle and kind mother.
Everybody miss me? What's life without a little pain? Father, everybody's dead. Give him a break. Go to find mother, no matter how long it takes me. My patience is waning. Die, everyone.
I'm gonna go get killed again.
Talk about a new level of daddy issues. I was like, are you seriously gonna do that all the way across the station? I can't even do one. I shouldn't be judging. Oh my goodness. Also, so many earworms tonight. I don't know which song is going to get stuck in my head the most, but if you come to my booth tomorrow and you just hear me humming, it's probably from tonight. Next, we have entry number 25 in the novice category. We have Izzy P cosplay. Cosplaying as Axe Boy from Identity B. Check this out, because y'all are really loud about that, and I don't know what it is. For years, he'd work at the orphanage, just gardening and taking care of his sister, until that tragic day. Now, Axe Boy, or as others know him, Robbie, has lost his head, and the boy who always cries had to pick up his axe to continue doing what he does best, .. recently, and now there's a scary thing that threatens my life. It feels like the right energy for what month is it? September. Yes, that's what it is. I know time. Time for entry number 26 in the novice category. We have Winter Valkyrie as Sophia from Persona 5 Strikers. My poor little ears. Initially built as humanity's companion to learn what a heart is for her creator, except ends up meeting the Phantom Thieves in result. With desires being stolen and the discovery of her creator not being as kind as she thought, confusion arises for this android as she learns the power of change. Soundtrack always hits a little bit different. All right, time for entry number 27. Woo. Yeah, go number 27. Woo! have PG and Asimone. I have so much power. They are cosplaying which Princess Peach and which Rosalina from Super Mario Bros. Oh, I lost the power a little bit. Today, these cosplayers will be showcasing their latest handmade cosplays for you all. This cosplay is a fan art by Mambobot on Twitter and Instagram. They got approval to do this from the artists themselves, so please enjoy their hard work.
Coming summer of 2024, Nintendo's very own Super Mario RPG. We have here some of our playable characters to show you today, such as Witch Princess Peach.
I am the princess.
And Warlock Rosalina. With special emotes you can get in our blind boxes. Show them your moves, Peach.
Turn up, baby. Turn up, baby.
Very good. Now, Rosalina. Amazing. All this could be yours and more for a small payment of $69.99. Extensive use of Mario RPG may cause harmful side effects such as money loss, hair loss, deformity of a skull due to headphone usage, distortion of time and how much you have of it, failing relationships with loved ones, and a sudden craving for peaches.
More the giant hats or Rosalina's long sleeves. Would that just be so fun to play with? Just like da, 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 da. Yeah, someone agrees with me. Thank you, one person who screams. Why are so many of you just everybody say way-o. There we go. Entry number 28 in the Masters category, we have Rosie Rhino as... Oh, they have light sticks, I'm scared. As level 90 White Mage Warrior of Light from Final Fantasy XIV. After all your friends' sacrifices, will you be strong enough to continue to the end? You can join Final Fantasy XIV now. It's free to play up to the third expansion, Stormblood. That's like three free games. Spoiler warning for end game content ahead. I'm gonna be plugging my ears real quick.
Here the path ends. There is no way to reach our nest. Hope cannot deliver you unto hopelessness. Our refuge is beyond you. Struggle will avail you not, nor will it grant your comrades peace.
These Alpus blooms serve as proof that this realm is not utterly devoid of hope. No more can you deny its power. No more is yours the dominion of despair. In case the practical implications were lost on you, your comrades no longer need fight their fight. So go on. Call them back to your side.
Heroic sacrifice paid off, I take it.
friends. Let us carry on and finish it together.
That was beautiful, but please be honest with me. Are you just a paid product placement ad for this game based on what I just had to read?
Sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends.
No, no, we're not. No. Next, we have entry number 29 in the Journeyman category. We have Pacific Sky Fish. Cosplaying as Mona from Honeyworks. Mona loves her fans that have always been there to support her. All of them, the ones that have been there from the start, who attend her concerts and write letters for her. She cherishes them so much and feels like it's because of them that she's grown stronger as an idol. This song, Fanza, is just for them. Was amused. Light sticks, put them up! I envy your energy. Like, you're always just like at 1,010% and you never stop. I love you guys so much. Yeah! All right, next is entry number 30 in the novice category. We have Lunar Rays. Yeah! As Nafika from Final Fantasy 14. Sun's sweet smile and wind's cool breath, both of these I send thee, to ripe thy fruit and spread thy seed and nourish those that tend to thee. Blessings of Nafika, the matron of... I'm just a cat, I'm trying. Gridania? Gridania. And the goddess of good harvests. Beautiful, beautiful. It's so funny. I was like, I'm sorry. She's like, it's okay. I'm just a cat. I don't know any better. Are you proud of me, Mom? I got a master's and I can just tell a whole crowd to meow on command. Welcome entry number 31 in the novice category. We have Shinobui Lee. As Natalie Watson Paquette from Apex Legends. Natalie Watson Paquette is a familiar face in the Apex games through Though for a different reason than most, daughter of the game's lead electrical engineer, she studied his manuals to stay close to him and discovered her calling at a young age. Though she could not be completely distracted one moment and hyper-focused the next, electricity grounded her. Its ordered, predictable flow made sense in a way the rest of the world didn't. They keep appearing out of new areas. What?
Introducing your champion.
My adversaries are in for a shock.
Charlie, a magical Leopleurodon. I know it's not a Leopleurodon, but that's all I can. Oh, if I have to remember the early 2000s YouTube, so do you. Next is entry number 33 in the Masters category. Woo! Yeah! We have Felix's Trinket Shop. As Cerberus Armor Ortho from Twisted Wonderland. Ortho Shroud is a first-year student at Night Raven College, a robot created in memory of Ida Shroud's deceased younger brother. His body is built to protect those around him. Despite being a robot, he is still very much human. I can jump. Whee! Her feelings to a certain Hylian.
Princess Zelda, late with a visiting to our domain soon.
Listen, I fell in love with her the moment I saw that character design, and she said, I love Mipha. All right, time for entry number 36. That's a good number. I like that number. I'm probably like one of the few people who's like, that's a good number. In the novice category, we have a Dahlia cosplay. They're cosplaying Juvia Loxer from Fairy Tail. Hide your ice, make wizard ladies and gentlemen, because here comes the water mage with a heart full of love. Because all I have to do is move from like point A to point B, and like that was such an amazing dance. Let's do another round of applause really quick. So good. All right, we have entry number 37 in the novice category. We have Lily Tries. Oh no, they have light sticks. Finish my part. They are going to be Vil Schoenheit from Twisted Wonderland. They're learning! After striving for years to follow in the footsteps of the Great Queen, Vil Schoenheit is reunited with her greatest rival, Neji LeBlanc. Yahoo!
in the magic mirror come from the farther space. Through wind and darkness I summon thee. Let me see thy face.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
Strange is thy beauty, Majesty, but hold, a lovely maid I see. Rags cannot hide her gentle grace. Alas, she is more fair than thee.
Alas for her. Reveal her name.
Lips red as the rose, hair black as ebony. Skin white as snow.
Snow white. A poisoned apple. Sleeping death. Oh, one taste of the poisoned apple, and the victim's eyes will close forever in the sleeping death.
Take a step into the heaven.
Recited on the rising of the first new moon to ask for the moon's blessing in the form of wealth and good fortune. For your purposes, the new moon you shall pray to is the first ever new moon in Tibet, since it's the first one you've seen here.
Oh!
Very threatening chair. Scary chair. Listen, I love Genshin Impact, and it has a death grip on my wallet. I know that Welcome Moon Girl. I see her every day. Let's welcome entry number 40 in the novice category. All right, get your light sticks ready. So Sunny is going to be cosplaying Maki Nishiki Kino from Love Live. I want to enjoy it all with everyone and get through it together. That's what it means to shine. And light people, if you're able to dim the lights a little bit, that would be awesome. I want to test if we're on the same TikTok algorithm. P for Papas. It's a Papas party. P for Papas. It's a Papas party. Yay! So many people are like, what's a Papas party? If you know, you know. And if you don't, okay, time for entry number 42 in the novice category. We have Onyx Urza cosplay. Cosplaying as the one and only Azula from Avatar The Last Airbender. Everyone thought she was always perfect, but all she wanted was her mother's love, and it led to her undoing. Black
fables, particularly fables. Although it reminds me of Vanessa. Okay, here I go.
Mix it up here in my little bowl. Say a few words and you lose control. I'm a hex girl and I'm gonna put a spell on you. I'm gonna put a spell on you. Yeah, I'm a hex girl and I'm gonna put a spell on you.
Charlie's cupcake.
You will be fog as I cloud your mind. You'll be dizzy when I make you sign. You'll wake up in the dead of night, missing me when I'm out of sight. I'm a hex girl, and I'm gonna put a spell on you. I'm gonna put a spell on you. Yeah. I'm a hex girl, and I'm gonna put a spell on you. Oh yeah. With this little cobweb motion, you'll fall into dark. If you ever lose affection, I can change your whole direction. I'm a hex girl, and I'm gonna put a spell on you. I'm gonna put a spell on you. Yeah, I'm a hex girl, and I'm gonna put a spell on you.
Way that just threw me back to my childhood. I was just like, yes, yes, I love that song. Time for entry number 44 in the novice category. We have Stardust Dream. Cosplaying as Yugiri, Saki, and Junko from Zombieland Saga. Stardust Dream is here to do their first performance for you all at Saboten, bringing you their favorite zombie idol group back to life. Yeah. Give it up for Yugiri, Saki, and Junko! Yeah.
Hello.
Saga.
Wow, they may be undead, but I think they- I'm happy those aren't groans. Time for our next competitor. Oh, the ninjas are back. Oh, hello. And there they go. Round of applause for the stage ninjas. Their invisible work has not gone unnoticed. So entry number 46 in the journeyman category, we have Autumn Days and KC Nomad. They are cosplaying Sora and Kairi from Kingdom Hearts. We went from meows to barks. Progression. When King Mickey is nowhere to be found, it's up to Sora to bring the magic for the Fantasmic show with the help of Kairi, of course.
Protect Disney, well, Disneyland.
Hundreds of dollars, which I will go spend at the artist alley. All right, time for entry number 48 in the journeyman category. We have BB and Lulu. Oh, I'm so excited. As Hatsune Miku and Marine Luca. Magical Mirai 2019 with us. Last time we did this, we celebrated Luca's 10th anniversary. This year, it's time to celebrate Miku's 16th birthday! I don't know if those are screams that you agree with me or screams that you disagree, but I'm going to think you agree. Time for entry number 49 in the novice category. We have Photo Fishy. They are going to be cosplaying as Fox Devil from Chainsaw Man. Bound by contract of public safety, Devourer of Mortals, the Fox Devil. Watch Chainsaw Man. But this is because my next hyperfixation, I am blaming you and all of you enablers. This will be your problem to deal with. It'll be like My Hero Academia all over again. All right. Entry number 50 in the Journeyman category, we have Griffhound. Hey, the Straggler. They are cosplaying as Dimitri Alexandra Blade from Fire Emblem Three Houses. Here to slay every last one of them. Hashtag feed the judges. All 2022 in the Masters category, we have Static Rabbit and Bunny Cuz! They're just, you know, cosplaying from a little indie game that you may have heard of. Link and Zelda from Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Specifically, costumes based on the designs presented. In the Broadway adaptation of Anastasia. 100 years ago, Hyrule fell to ruin. Calamity Ganon seized control over the kingdom, and with it perished the champions as well as their king. Princess Zelda and her guard Link are on the run, trying to save what little hope their once beautiful homeland has left. But even as the guardians catch up to them on the battlefield, one thing is for certain, they'll bless their homeland until they die.
Desert you, how to tell you why? Coachman, hold the horses, stay, I pray you. Let me have a moment, let me say goodbye.
They are cosplaying as Fukase from Vocaloid! forgotten by even the most devoted of fans, has come to perform for you today. You may know him by his alias, the Court Jester, or the weird one in a skirt. Hey! No matter how you may recognize him, or if you don't know him at all, he's here to put on a performance of a lifetime. Put your hands together, hands together, for the one, the only, Fugazi! Homura's heart has been progressively aching more with longing and grief. It doesn't help that no one else remembers what happened and that she's the only one who's still aware that Madoka even existed in the first place. Now, almost entirely consumed by despair, all Homura wants is to see Madoka again one last time. But what will happen when she gets her wish? Will she be the same person Madoka left behind? Or has she become someone else? I'm ready to cry!
Come on, Mama!
No words.
No?
I'm sorry it took so long, but I'm here now.
You don't know how long I've waited for this. I don't expect you to understand. This emotion is
more passionate than hope, much deeper than despair.
Girlfriends to be happy, but apparently that's too much to ask for. One day, maybe one day they can be happy, but not in this timeline. All right, two contestants left. Ooh. Entry number 55 in the novice category, we have Cowcat. Cosplaying Ryo Asuka, Satan form from Devilman Crybaby. The final and eternal judgment by God of all humanity. Turn that back on right now.
Ridiculous! You're human too!
Actually, I'm not, Akira. You see, I'm Satan. Love's not real.
I've seen love again, and your back is pretty tired, and we've drunk a couple bottles back, set our grief aside. You put your fancy on, I paid my fucking bill.
There's no rabbit in the sky.
Going out in style, babe.
I saw it with my own two eyes.
Say goodnight, love, while my organs
right, that one performance earlier convinced me to watch Chainsaw Man. I hope this convinces you to give Devilman Crybaby a shot if you're old enough to watch it. Please be old enough to watch it. That is your one warning. So now we have, one second actually. Hi, I don't know how to operate technology. I'm just a poor little cat. Meow, meow. Meow. Meow? Aha! Time for our last contestant! Woo-hoo! Welcome entry number 56 in the Masters category. We have Cake Monster Cosplay featuring Lulu Hartnett! I am going to read this verbatim. They are cosplaying Ya Boy Pit and Pit 2. I mean Dark Pit from Kid Icarus. After searching far and wide for Pandora's hideout, with the help of the godless Palutena, Pit confronts Pandora to put an end to all of her evil schemes. However, Pandora has a little surprise for our little hero. Will he succeed unscathed, or will he be forced to self-reflect? Appreciate the disembodied commentary.
I deal with this poser.
I'm not a poser. We're pretty much the same person.
No.
I'm just like you.
No, you're not.
You're just like me.
No way.
It's something anyone can see.
Enough. We're nothing alike.
Oh, come on. We're literally identical, except you're darker. Ooh. I think I'll call you Pit 2.
What'd you call me? My name is Dark Pit. Don't ever call me that again.
I mean, Mewtwo is kind of a cool, edgy counterpart of Mew, but what do I know? Wait! But what if you're a reflection of my true self?
Not again.
Who is this Pit I see?
Stop.
Back at me. When will my reflection show who I am inside?
Listen very carefully. I don't want to be like you. You are so obnoxious and overbearing. Your humor is the worst. Now then. Where was I?
Pitt, are you okay?
I'm not sure.
You know we still have to defeat Pitt too, right? Now along with Pandora.
Yeah. Hey, Palutena, is my humor that bad?
I find your humor charming.
Really?
Don't push it.
Right, I won't let you down. Pitu, I'm coming for you.
Don't you love when the main villain is just you confronting yourself in therapy? That shouldn't be relatable, but it is. Hi, you want to come up here? Oh my goodness! Guys, we got Greg. And before I give this over to you, I just want everyone to cheer for all of our contestants one last time! Our lovely judges have to go make the hardest decisions that they're gonna have to make. I do not envy you. That's why I'm up here and not down there. And here you go, Greg. What's up next?
Them. All right, so let's go ahead and send the judges down to be judgy. And while we're doing that, Kohei is going to get set up here. We're actually going to have two little mini events before we come back and do the final announcements. But before I get Kohei to start, I'm going to announce the winners for the photo contest over the weekend. If you are here when your name is called, please come up. If you're not here, I'm taking your prizes home with me. Amateur, second place goes to Robin Harrington. Bueller. Here we go. Congratulations. Yeah. Thank you. Congratulations. And for best in amateur, we have Sav Martinez. Yes? No? Yes. Okay. Congratulations. All right, for professional in second place, we have Nefi Lopez. I'm looking for movement, looking for movement. I get to keep these prizes. Mine. If anybody knows Nefi, let them know. We'll have the prizes over at operations and we'll contact them via email afterwards too. And for best professional in the photo contest, we have Squirtle Squad Photography. Yes, no, I'm going home with lots of prizes tonight. No. All right, with that being said, we got our judges down there. We got about a 20-minute halftime performance for you guys. And first up is Kohei.
Che. 1, 2, 1, 2. Sabate, come on, you guys going? You guys having a good time? You know, first of all, shout out to everybody. Make some noise for those amazing cosplayers. Yeah. This time, I want you guys...